Good morning, students. Welcome back to chemistry classroom. I hope all of you have enjoyed my video and understood. So I'm going to start the next topic. How chemistry evolved. Look at the heading. Human beings have continuously made efforts to lead a better life. They have looked for ways to improve the quality and yield of agricultural products. They have searched for ways to improve clothing and building materials as well. In addition, they have searched for medicines in order to cure disease. Chemistry began and evolved in the course of all this waste. So what do you mean from this part? Human beings are trying to comfortable our daily life. In this way, chemistry help to improve the quality and yield of agricultural product. It also helped to improve the clothing and the building materials. Same way, it helped to cure the disease. Next, the start of the chemistry in the Christian era in Egypt. Chemistry was first found in Egypt in the Christian era. The Egyptians were good at working with metals, glasses, and dyes. About that time, the Indians to work with metals. At the same time, Indians worked with metals, especially iron. They also prepared medicine from herbs and minerals. At the same time, Indians prepared medicine from herbs and minerals. Next topic is alchemy. What is alchemy? Before the chemist of today, there was alchemy. So, alchemy was there before the presence of modern chemistry. The word alchemy was derived by the Arabs from the Greek Egyptian word chemia. So, the alchemy is the Greek word. It was first derived from Arab and the Greek word is chemia. Alchemy was mainly practiced by the Arabs. So, the Arabians, those who practiced alchemy, they were known as alchemists. Who are alchemists? Those Arabians were practiced alchemy, they were known as alchemists. Greeks and Egyptians between the 8th and 16th centuries at AD. Next. Broadly, alchemists had the following two aims. Converting cheaper metals into gold. They tried to convert the cheaper metals into gold. Gold has been greatly valued by the human beings ever since it was discovered. It was first found at nuggets in some rocks, but rarely. So, alchemists made attempts to convert baser metals. Those metals are cheaper rather than gold. These type of metals they have to try and convert into gold like iron and copper. They tried for centuries and some claimed they had succeeded. And they believed that their success was due to the use of what they call philosopher's stone. So underline the red word philosopher's stone. What is philosopher's stone? Greek alchemists, those who had succeeded by the use of particular metals, these particular metals were known as philosopher's stone. Later, all these claims were proved false. The alchemists failed because their attempts were significantly wrong. You will learn in a later chapter that one metal cannot be converted. Into another metal by a chemical reaction. So, what do you mean from that? Any kind of metal cannot be converted into another metal by a chemical reaction. So, any metal cannot be changed by another metal by using chemical reaction. However, these experiments were useful in an important ways. They helped develop the art of extracting new metals. Which type of process they used by this that helped in later to develop the art of extracting the new metals? By using their process, we had known how to extract the new metals. The Indians had extracted iron much before this period. The quality of Indian iron was still was well known. Have you seen the iron pillar near Qutub Minar in Delhi? It was made in the 4th century AD. The 24 foot high pillar has been exposed to rain and storm since then. Yet it shows no sign of rusting. This is because the iron it is made of very pure. So, the pillar of the Qutub Minar is made of pure iron. That's why there was no sign of rusting. Searching for the elixir of life. Human beings have always wanted to live long. So, alchemists search for the elixir of life. What is elixir of life? Elixir is an imaginary liquid. Not it is a medicine. That is an imaginary liquid. By using that, they would cure all disease and help to person live long. That is elixir of life. So, elixir of life is, that is not an medicine. It is an imaginary liquid. By using that help to a person live long and cure all the disease. Next, why alchemy failed? The very basics of alchemy were incorrect. Alchemists accepted the ancient Greek belief that everything is made up of four substances. Ancient alchemists believed that everything is made up of four substances. These are earth, fire, air, and water. And no substance could be simpler than these four. So, another substance could not be simpler rather than these four substances, which were called elements. The alchemist tried to prepare substance of their choice by using these elements. So, I have discussed how chemistry evolved and alchemy. But from this topic, I will provide some questions. So, please note it down. The questions. First one is, what is alchemy? Next, who were alchemists? Next, what is philosopher's stone? And the last one is, what is elixir of life? I have provided you four questions and I hope all of you will write the question answer. So, for this portion for today. Thank you.